Laporte to come in through from the flank for Flandre. It's Damwon Kia. They're still biding their time.
They don't know where he is.
Opportunity as Mako goes in, pops immediately like a Balloon, but Canyon going to follow. So Flandre gets exhausted, and Khan now trying to continue this fight. Some low health bars as the flash comes forward. Khan goes golden. A Viper is still alive though. Flashes in. Showmaker down to 200. He's a sitting duck, and it's a double kill for Scout. Now he's flashing forward, picking up all of the summoner spells, and it is good night. Four Ghost and an ace for EDG.
What's up, everyone? I'm Captain Flowers, and I want to welcome you back to the Out Play-by-Play Worlds Edition. Bear with me as I'm feeling a little bit under the weather today, but that's not going to stop us from diving back in to the World Finals. Last episode, we broke down EDG's statement victory in game number one over heavy favorites in Damwon Kia. This time around, we're going to look at EDG's dominant Game 5 victory to put the final nail in the coffin. Let's take a deep dive into the action and see how the LPL squad dismantled the now former world champions to hoist the Summoner's Cup. Now, before we get into the final moments, let's take a look at both teams' drafts. What's important to understand here is the difference in advantage on both sides. Damwon draft a comp with powerful wave clear, pick potential, and decent team fighting with Trundle countering Xin Zhao. On the flip side, EDG go for a comp with heavy damage, engage, and poke with both Viper and Scout on their comfort picks of Felios and Zoe. With that in mind, it's crucial that both teams play to their strengths, as Damwon looked to snowball early with Showmaker running Predator Syndra for those early roams, while EDG looked to scale out to the late game for some clutch engages and 5v5 brawls. As the game kicked off, it was a battle between the junglers. With Canyon looking from a dive top, Flandre was put on the back foot after being forced to burn both his flash and TP for a reset, giving Khan the advantage. An advantage that didn't last for long. 8 minutes in, after Damwon took the first Drake, Flandre found himself right back in the game, securing first blood onto Beryl, who fell as the sacrificial lamb for Canyon to smite away Shelly. But the EDG top laner didn't stop there. He was out for blood and looking for revenge. With Khan returning to lane, watch as JJ and Flandre work together for the peekaboo jump scare to delete Khan before he can even blink. Damwon would attempt to return the favor to no avail, exhausting four players from a dive onto Scout, who just says, "See ya!" And for Khan, who was playing his last professional game, things only got worse with JJ's constant presence in the top lane.
All this gold funneled onto Flandre on this cannon, and with him reaching very close to level 11 and having his jungler here.
Khan, this is a problem. He's decided to commit, but he throws away the ultimate, and JJ's easily able to tidy it up.
As the game went on, both teams traded turrets and objectives for a near dead even gold differential. That was until EDG decided they wanted a war. 22 minutes into the game, JJ is spotted by Damwon, clearing a ward as both teams look to set up for the Ocean Drake. But take a look at Flandre, who sneaks right up behind his teammate and goes unseen in the fog of war to set up a bait and switch. Then, as Showmaker and Canyon step up, watch Flandre and the rest of EDG immediately pounce without any hesitation for the engage as they burn through the Korean mid laner while Canyon flashes away to safety. From there, Khan finds the kill into Viper as he flashes forward for the fadeaway ult. But pay attention to Scout, who plays a key part in this fight. Watch as he lands the Sleepy Trouble bubble onto Ghost as the Damwon Kia cavalry arrive to the scene. Because Ghost is CC and Canyon has half his health, Damwon lacked the engage and teamfight output to match the EDG firepower. So it's all downhill from there as Khan is the first to fall, with Canyon and Beryl joining him shortly after. Just like that, EDG had found the fight they needed in a 4-for-1 to begin pulling away and move to Soul Point. But Damwon aren't slouches when it comes to the art of the bait and switch either. 27 minutes in, take a look at the vision from EDG in the topside river. They can't see a single thing in the Baron pit. Now watch Damwon send both Canyon and Khan toward Baron while pulling the focus away from the objective at the same time. Beryl is actually the bait in this play, and eats a chain of CC before narrowly flashing away with just a sliver of health as Flandre chases him down. It's at this point that EDG are looking to destroy the mid turret, but with both Ghost and Showmaker arriving, the Ziggs wave clear is too strong and they're forced to back off. Then, when EDG finally sense what's going on, it's too late as EDG take the bait and Damwon take the Baron. But just shortly after, it was EDG who took control of the Ocean Soul off some beautiful coordination and team play from the LPL squad. Take a look at Flandre, who TPs into the Tri-Brush before blast-coning himself into the pit. Damwon at this point have no clue where the EDG top laner is. Now watch Mako, who sees a window of opportunity and sacrifices his life to dash in for the three-man knockup. EDG immediately follow up and instantly erase Canyon from the fight, preventing any chance of a smite steal. And so, the job was done. With Canyon dead, it was an easy smite for JJ, who safely secures the Ocean Soul, but falls to Khan in the process. But with Viper and Scout still alive, it was really just a carnage as the LPL squad picked them off one by one for the ace. With that next fight, EDG ripped through Damwon's mid tier 1 and tier 2 turrets before setting up for the next crucial objective of Elder Drake and Baron. As both teams play a game of chicken back and forth, waiting to see who bites first, take a look at Mako, who does not hesitate and finds the crucial engage onto Canyon to lock him up. Viper immediately bursts him down to less than half his health. However, Canyon looks to get out safely after using his pillar to zone the Aphelios away. But take a look at JJ, who dashes over the wall for the knockup, while Scout follows up with the Paddle Star plus Sleepy Trouble Bubble to dunk on the Damwon jungler. From there, it really was just a walk in the park for EDG, who make their way over to the Elder Drake. But pay attention to Showmaker, who's being zoned away and constantly harassed by Flandre to prevent him from resetting and TPing into the fight. At the same time, Viper goes on a rampage to delete Barrel, while Khan makes a last-ditch effort to steal the Elder Drake but gets punished instead. And so, EDG had played around their game plan to a T. With Viper and Scout unlocked, things were looking grim for the side of Damwon, who were looking for anything to turn the tides. 37 minutes into the game, take a look at Canyon, who finds himself behind enemy lines and is looking for a sneaky Baron play, but has no clue he's sitting right on top of an enemy ward. As EDG immediately collapses, Canyon realizes what's coming his way and looks for the great escape. But watch Mako, who's really just bullying Canyon at this point, charge in with his ultimate plus grand entrance to lock him up as EDG eviscerate the smite threat once again. With Canyon erased from the equation, it was a slow and painful bleed out for the LCK squad, who scrambled to destroy the tier 2 mid turret while EDG took Baron. Oh yeah, there was also Scout, who absolutely obliterated Ghost with the Elder Buff. Damwon would eventually trade that kill and go on to destroy the tier 2 bot. But at the same time, EDG were ripping through the top side, and Damwon's base came crashing down, slowly but surely, leaving just one Nexus turret between them and a world championship. With EDG charging forward and looking to end the game, watch JJ make the first initiation as he flashes for the engage onto Barrel. Mako and Viper immediately dash forward for the follow-up onto Showmaker, who desperately pops Zonius. Then, take a look at Flandre, who flashes in with the Slicing Maelstrom to first delete Showmaker and then Barrel for the double kill. From there, it's all but over from the side of Damwon as Viper destroys the remaining Nexus turret and Scout lands the Sleepy Trouble Bubble onto Canyon to send him back to the Shadow Realm as EDG rip through the Nexus to dethrone and upset the defending world champion. I'm Captain Flowers, and that's it for this week's episode and this year's final episode of the Out Play-by-Play. Let me know what you think in the comments. Was this the best Worlds ever? Do you have a different one in mind? Be sure to follow @LOL Esports on Twitter for everything League of Legends Esports, and I'll catch you back here next time.